Hi everyone, I am KAUSTUBH, AWS Certified Solution Architect and Developer, your multi-cloud DevOps guy. Thanks for all your response and support on the previous video. If you haven't checked out my previous videos, please go out and check them. I have videos on several cloud and DevOps topics, on Kubernetes, on AWS, Azure, GCP, Terraform, and other cloud and DevOps topics. So today we are going to talk about AWS budget reports.
In this video, we are going to do a full demo of AWS budget reports, and along with that, we will also learn what exact problem does AWS budget report solve for us in the real world. What are the limitations we should know before dealing with it, and what is the pricing we need to pay in order to use AWS budget report service. In the last video, we have discussed about AWS budgets, where we have performed a full demo of it as well, in which we have created a budget so we will be notified if we overspend the money in our free tier account. And especially in our case, we have set up this AWS budget named AWS total budget to track our cost. Before we start with AWS budget reports demo, let's talk about what problem does exactly AWS budget report solve.
So whenever you start learning anything, you must understand what problem it solves for you in the real world, because there are so many things out there and otherwise it will create you a confusion. And I am not going to learn everything until it helps to solve any of my problems. That is what matters to me. And AWS alone has around 200 services as of now, and not all of the services are used in real world. So the main advantage AWS budget report provide is that you can create a budget report for monitoring all budgets for all linked accounts in your organization. And also in the real world, not everyone is familiar with the AWS Console UI, right? And let me give you a pro tip. Managers and senior leaders love to see everything in Excel spreadsheets, as it also makes the data attractive and easier to understand with the help of multiple charts, formats, and we can also apply different formulas to make our data more relevant to us.
With budget reports, you can schedule regular reports to monitor your budgets. This report contains information about all your budgets which you have included while creating the budget report. Along with that, it also contains the current spend. With the help of budget reports, you can also create and send reports based on the time interval, that is daily reports, weekly reports, or monthly reports, to monitor the performance of your AWS budget. Budget reports also help you to create a report that monitors all your budgets for linked accounts belonging to a particular BU, that is business unit, and deliver it to the various team leaders of that BU, that is engineering leaders, product leaders, and the finance leaders. It is also used to improve planning and cost control with the flexible budgeting and forecasting. There is one limitation you need to know while dealing with AWS budget reports, that you can only create up to 50 reports for each standalone account or AWS organization management account. Now let's discuss the pricing of it. So it will cost you around $0.01 for each report delivered. This means whatever budgets you have included in that budget report, or whatever the source is there, whatever services you have included, regardless of how many email recipients you have included, no matter what, each budget report costs you $0.01 every single time. For example, a weekly report costs you $0.01 a week. Similarly, a monthly budget report costs $0.01 per month. So it will be $0.01 for every single report delivered, no matter what is the time interval, what is the email recipients you choose, whatever it's 50 or 20 recipients. So whatever we have learned till now, we can conclude that in a summary that AWS budget reports allow you to monitor the performance of your budget portfolio based on the time interval which you have selected, that is daily, weekly, on monthly basis, by receiving an email detailed report. And each report which is delivered to you will cost you $0.01. So So in the last video, we have created this AWS total budget. So you can see the details of it here. If you just select this budget, then you can see the preview of it, that it is a monthly budget. You can see here this red dashed line, which is at $0.01 cost, which is the minimum you can select in any of the AWS budget. And I have created this budget to monitor if we go over the free tier or not. And if that's the case happen, that if we go over the free tier, and then we will get an email alert. So that was the motto to create this AWS budget. And there is no graph for us because we literally just created this account and just created this budget. So we haven't used anything, and in cloud we have to pay for what we use. So currently I don't have any cost to pay. And down below you can see there is threshold, it is in okay state. So if you quickly go to this action button, you will see a option of create budget report. So just quickly select it. And here you can see we are on the creation page of AWS budget report. And if you have observed on the left hand side, we can see that we have moved from AWS budget to the AWS budget report section. And also the region is still the global. If you see above, the region is still global because AWS budget report is also a global service. And you will find the cost of all services which you are using from across all the regions. You will able to find it here. So let me first give it a name. So I will name it as AWS budget report. And in the second option, you can select the budget which you want to include in this report. So currently I have only one budget. But if you have multiple budgets in your account, then all will be shown here and you can select according to your need which you want to include in this report. So let's move forward, and here in the delivery settings, you can choose the report frequency from the daily, weekly and monthly, which we have already discussed while we're discussing the overview of this service. And next is the option of email recipient box. You can enter the email addresses of all the recipients to whom you want to send this AWS budget report to, like your financial leaders, product leaders, or you can add yourself. Just like in my case, it's a personal account, so I am adding myself. So let me enter my email address. And just without further wasting time, just click on create, and you can see that our budget report has been created successfully. And here you can also see the details about our budget report, that it is a daily frequency report, it has included one budget in it, and it has one email recipient. And if you want to edit this report, then you can just click over the report and you will be able to see the all options which you have selected. And if you want to edit them, then you can edit it. So if there is a requirement from your senior leaders or your financial leaders that you want the report now only, then you can just select this budget report and then click on this big download CSV button, which will download your budget report into a CSV data format, which is a comma separated values, which you can see in any of the spreadsheet applications like MS Excel or Google Spreadsheet, and you can analyze your course data so that you can make better decisions in the future.
If you found any new information through this video, then support me for free by clicking on the subscribe button and press the bell icon, so you will be notified of the next video as soon as I publish it. And also don't forget to like this video. See you guys in the next video. Till then, take care.